Hi, I'm Bill Burns. I'm an engineering geologist from the Oregon Department of Geology and Mineral Industries. Landslides in the United States cause an average of 25 to 50 fatalities and $3.5 billion in losses. In Oregon, including Portland, landslides are one of the most widespread and damaging natural hazards. And as population growth continues to expand and develop on landslide-susceptible terrain, increasing greater losses are likely. Landslides are generally not covered by homeowners insurance, so we must be proactive about reducing risk. Landslides are a chronic hazard in Oregon, and annual average losses from landslides in Oregon are estimated at over $10 million. However, most of Oregon's landslide damage and losses is associated with severe winter storms, such as the February 1996 event, where losses from landslide damage can exceed $100 million. Landslides induced by earthquake shaking are also likely in many parts of Oregon, and losses associated with landslides in moderate to large earthquakes are likely to be significant. The general term landslide refers to a range of mass movement, including rock falls, debris flows, earth slides, and other types. It is important to understand that all of these different types of landslides have different frequencies of occurrence, speed of movement, triggering conditions, and thus different resulting hazards. All landslides can be classified into one of the following five movement types: slides, flows, spreads, falls, and topples. Most slope failures are complex combinations of these distinct types, but the generalized grouping provides a useful mean for understanding the types of hazard associated with the type of the landslide, the characteristics, identification methods, and potential mitigation alternatives. All of these types of landslides occur in Portland. Some of the most common are shallow earth flows and deep rotational slides, especially in the West Hills. Some of the steep drainages in the Portland Hills also can have channelized debris flows, which start up at the crest of the drainage, pick up speed and water and debris on the way down the drainage, and engulfing everything at the mouth of the drainage. Rock falls are also common in areas where we have vertical escarpments. Within every landslide is a battle between the driving forces and the resisting forces. When the driving forces win or the resisting forces lose, a landslide occurs. And factors which increase these driving forces and thus tend to destabilize slopes include the addition of water and or weight to the crest of the slope. An example of increasing the resisting forces, which tends to increase the stability, include removal of water from the slopes or buttressing the toe of the slope with a retaining wall. Areas that are more prone to landslides include areas with steep slopes, canyons, and areas at the mouth of the drainage, and areas that have had past movement. Monitoring your house and surrounding property for signs of landslide activities can be done through things like looking for newly cracked pavement, cracks in your foundation, cracks in your in small retaining walls or in the sidewalk, tilted or cracked chimneys, doors or windows that stick or jam for the first time, outside walls or walkways or stairs that start to pull away from your house, areas where you've seen soil pulling away from your foundation, maybe plumbing or gas lines that have developed leaks, leaning fences, posts or retaining walls, springs, seeps, or saturated soil areas that have been typically dry, and cracks in the ground, or tilted trees or utility poles. You can monitor your existing property for signs of landslide activity, like cracks in the ground or foundation, jammed doors and windows. You can also monitor your stormwater intake areas like roofs and driveways and outlets like the roof gutter drains to ensure you are not discharging water into a landslide prone area. Other things to consider include minimizing irrigation on slopes and making sure that water and sewer lines do not leak. Also, avoiding removing material from the base of the slope or adding material or excess water to the top of the slope. Drain water from surface runoff, downspouts, and driveways well away from slopes and into storm drains or natural drainages. And plant ground cover with deep roots on slopes and build retaining walls at the base of the slope. Finally, if you have any other concerns about your existing property when building a new home, project, or purchasing an existing structure, you should consult a certified or licensed engineering geologist or a registered or licensed professional geotechnical engineer. We have created a fact sheet which is available at this website, which goes into more detail about these different types of landslides. There is also an excellent guide for homeowners to landslides on our website, located here. And we have created a website which identifies many of the areas with known past movements called Slido, which is available at this website.